So the Mem mobile app is finally out. It's in public beta, and I wanted to use this video to show how you can utilize it on the go. All right, so if we go right into the mobile app, you can see that there are a couple nice menus in here. So on the top left, there's a spot for any of your starred Mems. So if you have any sort of favorites that you need to use when you're on the go, if you want to start before you head out, let's say we had an example for a recipe here. If I open up this recipe, then if I go to the top right and press star mem, this mem was starred. The mem has been added to your starred mems in your sidebar. So if we press this here, you can see add a recipe title is there. And then for this one, there's actually a blank list that I had. So if I unstar this mem, this right here is going to be an example of what starred mems I could have on the go. Now, if I make a new one here, let's look at how good the functionality is regarding the basic interaction with the application. So if I go into this, you can see it has actually a pretty decent look for what the different types of sectioning is for the text interactivity. So there's a spot for you to type out different H1s. So make this the title. And then if that's what you'd want to star, then I could press the star mem on the top right. And after you refresh, it actually is having some issues taking this over here. So if I show you once again, there is some invisible space here. So if I press this, it would make it show, but that's not a great look. That's not actually a great start here, but let's work with the functionality of the hashtag. So if I put recipes here, you can see it's got an option to add it to an already existing hashtag, which is really nice, or create a new one. So that markdown functionality is actually working pretty well on the mobile app. And then if we go into something like the checklist, this works well. And let's see how the rest of this works. So if I press this underline functionality, I can highlight text, underline it, strike through, italicize, code it, switch to a quote block. So the block functionality here is actually not too bad for a mobile app. I like this a lot. In comparison to some other mobile apps, it works pretty well. And then you have the option to take a photo. So I could take a photo of what's going on right here, use this photo, and I could drop this right into the application. And if we want to press the related mems here on the top right of any of these, you can actually see the relation functionality that works here. So what's interesting in the top right is it actually can show you, say for example, you wanted to keep a log of your daily mems in the start section. So if I take this guy and star it and then move it to the move over here, you can see that this had a title and I properly made a title, so it's going to show rather than the make this the title, which messed up the functionality, and it like looks like it's invisible. So I'm going to unstar this mem and go back into here, and if I press the related mems, I could actually see the entirety of everything, so then I could interact with all of the different daily mems that I had. And then you can't press the hashtag here, but it's going to showcase these to you in a format where it would just break it down by the different hashtags that exist. Now, if I want to do a, this is a test, I want to do a test regarding the search functionality. So if we go into the search section, I'm going to type this as a test. And as you can see, it doesn't actually have the capability of finding text within mems too well, because I don't have a lot on my account and I typed this as a test. So if, even if I just type test, it's not going to find it. So this is basically based off of the different titles that are there, as well as the tags that are there. So if I type in daily mem, this would show by tags. And then there's actually a little bit of functionality here regarding the ability to search by different tags. So if I had something titled daily mem, but I just wanted to find it for the tags, I could click on that there and it would only show it from there. And then if you want to edit it by who is the person that interacted with it, I could press that and then filter it out by that as well. And then obviously on this, you could actually see mems that are shared with you, just created mems by yourself, and then all of them together. And in this whole functionality, it's pretty solid, but there is probably going to be a fair amount of updates to this app as it is a public beta app and it's not actually on the App Store yet. There's a lot of work to be done here, but it's not bad. If you want to check out my other video on Mem, make sure to go here to see a deeper dive into the application itself.